The coronavirus pandemic is forcing businesses, big and small, to rethink how they manage their workforce. As companies begin to rely on telecommuting, how will a remote workforce affect day-to-day operations, morale, and obviously the bottom line? Let's bring in the CEO of Kaye, Bassman International, Sanford Rose Associates, Jeff Kaye. Jeff, good morning.
Good morning.
You know, it's fascinating because the capability of remote working in this country in general, of the U.S. workforce, it's 56%. So we've already seen a trend towards this before the coronavirus outbreak.
What we're seeing right now is some people are used to this, right? So the word we're using is kind of triage your home. So think of some people have been used to working out, and they've developed those muscles. Other individuals have metaphorically not been into that gym. So they have to figure out how are they going to navigate around the ever-changing needs. They've got their home is now their gym. It's their restaurant. It's the business source of business. It's actually the school for some people. And so think of the kind of constant information and the chaos that's coming their way. How do you minimize distractions? How do you create sort of a manufacturing process at your home to think of if you were building a product providing a service, how would you compartmentalize it and do it the most effective, efficient, and productive way possible? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Navigating through the idea that some are going to have, you know, isolation and others are going to have chaos. And it just depends on what you've been used to,
okay,
as to what you're going to react.
Let me ask you about the chaos part of it. I can't tell you how many emails I've gotten from my friends with kids at home that are not no longer in school and they're working from home and they're pulling their hair out for the most part. So how do people minimize distractions at home so that this doesn't hurt them in their professional life?
Well, that's a great question. So, you know, people have been spending their entire lives creating their resumes and their LinkedIn profiles. Now you get a chance to show that you really are what you've said that you are. This is the proverbial X factor that people talk about. This is what it looks like. So individuals have an opportunity to be able to demonstrate that they're the kind of individuals that can lead. They're the individuals that are encouraging and other individuals and leading with those best practices. Companies get a chance to show that, guess what, those mission, vision, and values that they've created, they get to live by those too. So if everybody operates sort of in a fishbowl, as if, are you behaving in a way that you would behave if you were at work, or if your coworkers were there, or from a leader perspective, what does that look like? So we have 110 offices all over the country, even ones in Hong Kong and Singapore, and every industry, function, and geography you can imagine, and it's very situational by the industry, but people get a choice right now to show who they are, not just tell us who they are.
Well, look, hey, you know, $35 billion a day is the same productivity number here. I think a lot more companies are going to go this route after this virus is over. Jeff, thank you very much for being here. Jeff Kaye.
Thanks, my pleasure.